catch my breath.
Oh yeah, don't have any cap points. I guess I need to be closer.
Not to see it again, that's for sure.
Let's not stand around. Predators like these can smell spilled blood a mile away.
What's that? Sort of note on the ground. What? Oh my gosh. Where are they? I'm not the scrolls I had. Huh. Actually, I don't see him. Maybe I sold him.
Let's turn someone inside out.
What?
for you in Baldur's Gate, Astarion. A sweetheart, perhaps?
Not one in particular. The city is a veritable feast of sweethearts.
You must be eager to get back, then. Slimmer pickings out in this wilderness.
Go that way. I don't quite get it. Maybe it's useful. Does anyone have this? I'm not sure. Maybe the cleric has it. I'm not sure though. I'm not sure about this last one. Yeah, I want to stay Arcane Trickster.
shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Seek and you shall find me.
Breathing, despite everything.
A long way from Waterdeep.
I have something to ask.
The Blade of Frontiers at your calling. Karlak's fires raged in Baldur's Gate before she escaped to Avernus, as my source told it, and she was planning to return. One of the archdevil Zariel's own, chaos incarnate, a devil with pure fire for a heart. I made my way to Avernus to stop her. She fled from my reach. Even climbed aboard the Mind Flayer ship as it screeched through the hells. I followed in close pursuit. I can't bear to imagine the lives Karlak might be taking, the damage she might be doing. A powerful friend with a keen interest in privacy. I'm sworn to say no more. All right. What else is on your mind? A most vicious one, in fact. It's made from pure bloodstone, carved from the Galena Mountains just north of the Moonsea. A reminder that sometimes blood must be shed and sacrifices must be made. But that story is reserved for lifetime friends and calmer days. By all means. What else is on your mind?
Few warlocks in my time. Talented, of course, though sometimes too eager to listen to the devils on their shoulders. Comes with the territory, unfortunately. I question the wisdom of that decision, but so be it. I'll be here in the meantime, idling away the hours.
Well met. That's the spirit. Well met.
I've come to know a fair few village clerics, but none with the skill to pull these worms from our heads.
From what I understand, there's a healer called Nettie in the grove. Perhaps she's got the talent. We should pay her a visit.
My father once said, one does not pursue a champion's life. One merely answers its call. So it was for me. I was hunting near the Cloakwood when I heard it. A child crying out from a lone farmstead. I found him in the fields flanked by goblins. His mother's corpse bled into the soil next to him. I don't remember much of the battle, but I remember drying the boy's tears after. No. But he named me friend. And that meant the world. But what of the others? The children never saved. The cries never heard. In the boy's tears, I finally saw the suffering wrought by the villains of the wild. The frontiers demanded a blade. And so I heeded. I shouldn't be surprised. You are a great talent. When darkness falls, you make your own light. The helpless, though, they need the light of others. They're the ones who seek out the blade.
Thank you.
wasn't expecting for him to turn level 3. I thought he was just going to be level 2 and be weaker. Spell.
Whatever comes, I'm ready.
A heroic heart. Thank you.
Let's get going. Well, that ends not as bad as it could have.
A long way to go still.
All right, what now?
Well met.
Lady of Sorrows, guide us. Did you want something?
Don't sleep well, flitting between dreams and nightmares. Maybe you wake up because you know something is wrong, or maybe you just get lucky.
Shit. No, no, it's not what it looks like. I swear. I wasn't going to hurt you. I just needed, well, blood.
There, in the dim firelight, you see him for what he really is. A vampire, a slave to sanguine hunger.
Hmm.
this is a hard choice. Let's see.
I've never killed anyone. Well, not for food. I feed on animals, boars, deer, kobolds, whatever I can get. But it's not enough. Not if I have to fight. I feel so weak. If I just had a little blood, I could think clearer, fight better. Please.
A strange
Yo, he already bit me.
Courses through you, and your companion's mind unfolds, secrets half revealed.
He already bit you, you idiot.
You focus on the source of the power, but it is quiet and still. It needs to rest.
No. No, of course. Silly of me to even ask. I'll go and find something on four legs to eat, I suppose. See you in the morning.
You watch him stalk away, slumped, sulking, and ready to kill.
Morning. I hope last night's little unpleasantness hasn't left a bad taste in your... Well, I hope there are no bad feelings. Indeed, it could. These are very helpful in a fight. Of course, I can't summon wolves or turn to mist like a true vampire. Being a spawn has its drawbacks. Oh, I've no idea. For 200 years, the sun would have turned me to cinders. Until the crash, when I woke up bathed in its light. Someone, or something, wants me alive. They've changed the rules. Standing in the sun, wading through a river, wandering into homes without an invitation. They're all perfectly mundane activities now. As for my other quirks, well, we can figure those out in time. No more surprises. You have my word. I'm just glad you're being sensible about these revelations. I was worried people might turn up with torches and pitchforks. Although there's still time.
A vampire? Well, that explains the pallor. Given our group's nature, I don't see much harm. We're each monsters in the making, after all.
Fine. As long as he keeps his fangs off our necks.
Quite the opposite. I'm here in the spirit of openness and honesty. To work together as a team.
I'd just better not wake with any holes in my neck.
There now. We're all friends again. Shall we go? There's a long day ahead of us.
Well met.